advocacy groups officially kick off efforts to oust Vice President Sara Duterte. This afternoon at the House of Representatives, an impeachment complaint was filed against the embattled official following a resounding backlash over threats to have the first family and the House Speaker assassinated. Akbayan Congressman Percy Sandania endorsed the civilian-led complaint, with former Senator Laila De Lima joining Monday's complaint filing. Sandania, in a statement, said the vice president deserves to be booted out of office for her alleged abuse of power and plunder of state coffers. To recall, the VP is facing scrutiny at the House over her alleged misuse of millions of pesos worth of confidential funds. The Constitution allows impeachment on several grounds, among them betrayal of public trust. The impeachment complaint first goes through a House committee with a one-third vote in the chamber required to impeach an official. This then goes to the Senate, which, as an impeachment court, will decide whether to convict or acquit the official. The Philippine National Police says so far it has not received any information on a credible death threat against Vice President Sara Duterte. PNP spokesperson Jean Fajardo, however, notes the police remains vigilant about Duterte's situation and assured her of her security. Last week, the vice president alleged that the government was ignoring threats to her life, which she said were well documented. The Philippine military has also vowed to temporarily replace members of the Vice Presidential Security and Protection Group with new personnel from the Armed Forces of the Philippines and the National Police. The National Security Council slams the insistence of the Makabayan Bloc of lawmakers to pursue an impeachment case against Vice President Duterte. NSC Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya said the progressive lawmakers in the House are trying to create an impression of instability in the Philippine government. They are set to file a separate impeachment case against the country's second top official this week.
Concerned ang National Security Council, we condemn this kind of statement coming from Makabayan dahil this goes against the spirit of what the President said. Itong impeachment complaint will distract the nation from the more pressing problems that we are facing.
Philippine House lawmakers back a proposal to investigate vloggers and so-called internet trolls spreading fake news against leaders and members of the Quad Committee. Members of the Young Guns in the lower house underscore the importance of fighting against organized disinformation campaigns online. Party List Representative Rog Gutierrez argues, while freedom of speech is protected under the Constitution, it has to be tempered with responsible practice and use. For House Assistant Majority Leader Sia Lonto Adyong, he cited the dangers of allowing disinformation to run rampant, saying lawmakers and their families have been receiving threats. This proposal was raised by Surigao del Norte Representative Ace Barbers, citing the adverse impact of troll campaigns on House investigations, as he urged authorities to safeguard public discourse. The Russian attack submarine that was spotted off the coast of Occidental Mindoro has left the West Philippine Sea. National Security Council Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya says the foreign vessel was only exercising its freedom of navigation when it was traversing the waters inside the Philippines' exclusive economic zone. Malaya insists the Russian vessel still had the right to pass through the area.
Part pa rin yan ng high seas, kaya kahit sinong barko ay pwedeng dumaan dyan. So long as hindi siya naglo-loiter or hindi siya kumukuha ng mga natural resources, o kaya naman meron siyang ibang ginagawa na hindi tama, no? Gaya ng paggawa, for example, ng Marine Scientific Survey. So in this case, hindi naman ginagawa ng barkong yan.
The Philippine Coast Guard earlier confirmed the passage of the Russian submarine. The Russian vessel, however, stated it was only waiting for weather conditions to improve before proceeding to Vladivostok, Russia.